the Lord. God bless you. I'm Pastor Gemma Winger, and you're watching Beauty for Ashes. I have a very special guest with me today, Charlie McDonald, Pastor Charlie McDonald. He is a mighty man of God. He's a general contractor by trade. He runs an amazing business for the Lord. He serves God in everything that he does. So welcome to the show, Pastor Charlie.
Thank you very much, Gemma. Pleasure. It's a blessing. Thank you.
God bless you. Well, we're going to open up with prayer. So let's bow our heads and pray right now. Oh, Jesus, we cry out to you. We pray for breakthrough, breakthrough, breakthrough. Thank you, Father God. You are a miracle-working God, and your children need a miracle. Right now, we thank you, Father God, that you are parting that Red Sea, that your children will miraculously go over on dry land in the name of Jesus. God, we just thank you, Lord. You said that those who know their God shall do exploits, and we are believing for signs and wonders and miracles. They said, surely, hallelujah, this man is of God, that God is with him because of the signs and the miracles that Jesus did. So we thank you, Father God. We praise you, Lord. You're a God who answers prayer. We know the effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man avails much. So we are those righteous men and women. We are praying. We are seeking your face. Hallelujah. We are asking. We are seeking. We are knocking. We're not going to give up. We're not going to turn back. We're going to press through. We're going to press on to the mark of the prize of the high call in Christ Jesus. We're going to run this race to win it. And nobody, nothing, hallelujah, is going to destroy our faith. Nobody and nothing is going to stop the blessing of God from coming our way, because we are not going to allow it, in Jesus' name. Oh, Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for your Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord, for your anointing. Right now, we're just going to humble ourselves before the Lord. Hallelujah. It's God's ministry. It's God's vision for your life. It's God's dream. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So just give it to him and let him do it. And don't worry about anybody else or how God is using anybody else. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Well, to start out, God gave me a very special scripture, Psalm 71, verse 20. You have shown me great and sore troubles. You have been through great trials and tribulations, situations that were devastating, that were hurtful, that were tragic. But you shall quicken me again. God's going to quicken you again. God is going to make all things new. The Lord is going to heal and restore. He binds up the brokenhearted and he heals their wounds. He's going to comfort all who mourn in Zion. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You had dreams, you had visions, and then the enemy came and brought sickness into the camp, brought divorce, brought death. Hallelujah. But the Lord is going to quicken you again. The Lord is going to make all things new, and what he creates now is going to be greater than what was lost in the past. And you shall bring me up again from the depths of the earth. The Lord is going to bring you up again. But when you're at your lowest point, it takes faith to believe. When you don't see anything happening, it takes faith, hallelujah, to stand on the word of God and trust him in all situations, in all circumstances, that truly everything we know works together for good to those who love him and are called according to his purpose. And you shall increase my greatness. The Lord is going to increase your greatness. The Lord is going to raise you up. He raised up Joshua in the eyes of the people, hallelujah, after Moses' death. The Lord raised up Moses and caused people to follow him. God will cause people to come to you. God will cause people, hallelujah, hallelujah, that you minister to, that you speak to, that you pray for, that you touch. God will bring people to you. Hallelujah. He says, you shall increase my greatness and comfort me on every side. He will increase your greatness. It's not you increasing your greatness. It's not you promoting yourself. It's the Lord increasing your greatness and comforting you on every side. Why does he say he's going to comfort you? Because there's so many situations where you're going to need comfort, where you're going to need love. There are so many attacks of the enemy. Hallelujah. But God is there to make you strong.
Beautiful. Praise the Lord, sister. That was wonderful. Beautiful. You know, it's funny. Today is Valentine's Day.
Yes.
Let the world rejoice for Jesus. That's where your heart should go out there. And in John 7, it's verse 37. It's the promise of the Holy Spirit. And I just want to bring this to everyone's attention out there that if you're giving your heart in vain and to the world and to the natural, you might want to think again, because your really heart deserves to go to Jesus. Jesus said, if anyone thirsts, let him come to me and drink. He who believes in me, as the scripture has said, out of his heart will flow rivers of living water. That is life. God has life for you. If you keep looking in the natural in the world, that's why your life is always being bumped and failed. Seek Jesus. Look what he just says to you for Valentine's Day. Out of his heart will flow rivers of living water.
Praise
what
God.
A beautiful gift. Amen?
The best gift of all.
Thank you, Jesus. The true love of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Psalm 72, verse 18. Blessed be the Lord God, the God of Israel, who only does wondrous things. We are believing God that he is going to do wondrous things, that he's going to heal that body. He's going to increase that ministry. He's going to bring prosperity and finances. He's going to deliver from addiction. Hallelujah. He's going to deliver from the spirit of suicide and oppression and depression in Jesus' name. He alone does wondrous things, and we're going to believe him for those miracles. I know that you've been waiting a long time, but your blessing comes from the hand of the Lord. Please him, serve him, don't worry about what man says, because God is going to bring the miracle. From his hand comes the miracle. And blessed be his glorious name forever. And let the whole earth be filled with his glory. So we're going to praise him. We're going to bless his name. We're going to glorify his name. We're going to honor him. We're going to cry out to God that the whole earth would be filled with his glory. We want his glory to come down in this place right now. We want his glory to come upon those who are listening. Let him fill you. Just relax. Just rest in him. Hallelujah. Just relinquish all control. Let Jesus have full control and give him that thing that is concerning you. Give him that worry. He will take care of it, and he is taking care of it. Have faith.
Faith. Let faith work its perfect patience and perfect works.
Amen.
Beautiful. That's in the book of James, where
yes,
he teaches us patience. But I'm going to go back to John chapter 14. So I'm stuck on the heart today, because in the secular world, everybody celebrates the heart and loving in the world and in the flesh. But I'd like you all out there to repeat what I say. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. In John 14, he says, let not your heart be troubled. He doesn't want you to be troubled. He wants you to have a good, wonderful, wholesome life. He says, you believe in God, believe also in me. Before in my Father's house are many mansions, if it were not so, I would have told you, I go up to prepare a place for you. And Jesus is talking to you out there. I praise the Lord and ask an anointing on your life that if you have the ear to hear tonight, that Jesus is calling upon your life tonight to give up your old wicked ways. Put on a new man. Shed the world and renew and restore through Jesus Christ. And you do that on Valentine's Day because it's through the heart. So through your heart, you can renew and reconcile and restore your whole inner man. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen. That's so powerful because in Psalm 73, Asaph, who was David's chief musician, says, as for me, my feet were almost gone. My steps had nearly slipped. So he had almost backslidden. But what caused him to go in the wrong direction? Why? For I was envious at the foolish when I saw the prosperity of the wicked. Where are you looking? Who are you looking at? What is important to you? Are you looking at those who are rich and wealthy and famous but aren't serving God? Are you looking at those who are preaching and teaching the word of the Lord, who are singing for the Lord? Hallelujah. But maybe they don't have as much in their pockets. They don't have the finances, he said. But as for me, my feet were almost gone. My steps had well nigh slipped, for I was envious at the foolish when I saw the prosperity of the wicked. Hallelujah. They are not in trouble as other men. You know, wealthy people, they get more attention. They get more time. They get more privilege. Neither are they plagued like other men. Their lives are easier. He was looking at a rich person or rich people in general and seeing that their lives were easier. Therefore, pride compasses them about as a chain. Violence covers them as a garment. Their eyes stand out with fatness. They have more than their heart could wish. They are corrupt and speak wickedly. Concerning oppression, they speak loftily. So we see these rich, these famous people filled with pride, filled with sin, filled with corruption. Their hearts are not pure and holy before the Lord. Hallelujah. And then he said in verse 12, behold, these are the ungodly who prosper in the world. They increase in riches. He was looking at the ungodly who had increased in riches. And then he says, truly, I have cleansed my heart in vain and washed my hands in innocency. For all the day long have I been plagued and chastened every morning. He's talking about the trials and the tribulations of those who are serving God, those who are doing the right thing, those who are honoring the Lord. Hallelujah. And then he said, until I went into the sanctuary of God, then I understood their end. When I got before the Lord, when I sought the face of God, I no longer envied the wicked. I no longer thought they were so great. Why? Surely you did set them in slippery places. You cast them down into destruction. How are they brought into desolation? As in a moment, they are utterly consumed with terrors. As a dream when one awakes, so, O Lord, when you awake, you shall despise their image. Hallelujah. When they die, they're not going to heaven. They're going to hell for all eternity. Thus my heart was grieved, and I was pricked in my reins. So foolish was I and ignorant. I was as a beast before you. Don't get your eyes on the world and the things of the world, the things that money can buy. People are lying, stealing, cheating so that they can have more stuff, more land, more houses, right? But what is their end going to be? And that is the most important. We are living our life for the afterlife, to have eternal life with the Lord Jesus Christ. Nevertheless, I am continually with you. You have held me up by your right hand. Hallelujah. We are continually with the Lord. He says he will never leave us or forsake us, that he's blessing us with enduring riches, and we have to keep looking at the Lord, keep trusting in God. Hallelujah. You know, Charlie, you gave a testimony earlier that you had a job right there on Chautauqua, and tell us what happened.
Yes, it was right in front of my job there in the
Pacific
Palisades. As Jim has said, the Pacific Palisades, where people have a lot of money and they race their sports cars up and down the block.
It was a Ferrari.
And, not to mention any names, but there was a professional event, you know, going on up there, and they were just going too fast and knocked over a pole, and the driver was, you know, killed instantly, enjoying the fruits of the world. And this is what happens when you enjoy the fruits of the world and you don't come before the Lord, like Gemma was explaining. You've got to get in the face of the Lord to understand what he wants, because it's all about faith. When you have that faith, it builds confidence in your God. And those out there that have your Bible, quickly turn to James chapter 1. It says, my brethren, verse 2, count it all joy. Listen, he says, count it all joy when you fall into various trials. So what happens is the unbeliever and the weak spirit, when they get into a trial that they can't get out of, or it's very difficult to handle financially or emotionally, maybe they take drugs, maybe they start drinking, and they just get their life going downhill further. But Jesus says, when you get a trial in your life, count it as joy, amen?
Yes.
And he says, when you fall into various trials, knowing, you know, when you come to Christ, that it's the testing of your faith, listen, produces patience, okay? That's what the world needs right now. We need patience out there by the byways and freeways. But let patience have its perfect work, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing. Listen, lacking nothing. You have the Spirit of God. If any one of you lacks wisdom, now, you don't have to go to college for this out there. Listen to what the Lord says to you. This is the Lord speaking to you. If any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives it to all, how? Liberally. God's not a cheap God. He's an infinite God. He gives it liberally without reproach, and it will be given to him. But let him ask in what?
Faith.
Faith. Gemma, see that? Gemma's very big on faith and coming before the Lord. And this is what we need to do. We need to preach that gospel of coming before the Lord to change and reconcile your spirit. Amen?
Yes, yes. And then what I was saying also ties in with that, because Asaph says, I was so foolish and ignorant, because I looked at the wicked and I envied the wicked and I envied what they had and I envied how the world treated them. But I didn't look at what their end would be. So if our eyes are on the world, hallelujah, someone's handbag, someone's outfit, someone's shoes, hallelujah, that's not where our heart should be. Our heart should be in prayer, seeking the face of God, asking for his wisdom, walking in obedience to him, mm-hmm. and serving him and speaking the word of God. That is what is truly important. Don't get distracted by the world and what the world has to offer, because you're going to lose your faith. Just as Asaph said, he almost slipped. His feet almost slipped when he was envious of the wicked. And he says, again, the Lord says, nevertheless, I'm continually with you. You have held me up by my right hand. So Asaph says that to the Lord. Lord, you are continually with me. You have held me up by your right hand. And I had two visions of the Lord's right hand that literally he's lifting you up. He's strengthening you. He's giving you the strength that you need to survive, because the trials and the tribulations that are going on in this world are so horrific. Hallelujah. And the destruction that the enemy is bringing upon this land is meant to destroy you, is meant to kill you, is meant to break you. Hallelujah. But you're going to stand strong in the Lord. The Lord is going to lift you up by his strong right hand. Hallelujah. You shall guide me with your counsel and afterward receive me to glory. Are you being led by his counsel? Are you being guided by him? Are you pressing in to really hear his call, his voice, his wisdom, his direction?
Oh, that's beautiful. Are you hearing the word of God? You know, God talks to you out there, whether you're up or down. Remember, Paul says that he's content no matter where his life is, right?
Yeah.
So you don't have to have $1 million and a Ferrari and deal with that. You can be struggling for your rent, but if you love Jesus, you're complete. He says, I'm complete. But I want you to picture something out there right now. In James chapter 2, verse 14, I want you to understand one thing, that if you have a job, right, and you have faith, right, you have the faith that you have the job, but if you have the faith and you don't go to work, are you going to get paid, right? So James 2, 14, he says, what does it profit, my brethren, if someone says he has faith but does not have works? Can faith save him? No. For as the body without the spirit is dead, so the faith without works is dead also. So you got to get up and get out there. You got to preach that word of God. Talk it up among your friends. Read the Bible. Get yourself a Bible. Get yourself a new life. Remember, today's Valentine's Day, and God's going to put a new heart in your spirit man today.
Amen. Praise the Lord. So what I see the Lord is telling us today, to get on the right track in our mind, in our hearts, in our actions, in everything that we say and do. We have to get focused on the Lord. Our mind has to be off the world and the things of the world and truly be separated to him. Hallelujah. Charlie, would you lead us in prayer right now? Hallelujah. Those who are desiring more of the Lord, those who want a greater touch from him, hallelujah. Those who need to see a move of God in their lives, those who need to see a miracle. Let's pray right now. Let's come in agreement.
Praise the Lord. Lord, we just come in agreement with you, Lord, right now. Father God, we ask the watchers, the viewers, the hearers, Father God, that we just see if they're lonely today on this special day in the world, but if they're alone, they don't have anybody. Let them cry out for Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus is your heart today. Cry his name out. Jesus, I need you. Don't be afraid. Jesus wants you to call his name out. He's got cover for you. He's got protection. He's got eternity and salvation. Hallelujah, Lord. We pray, Lord, that you just pick the ones that are weary, Lord God, and give them strength. God says when you're weary and weak here that he will lift you up. He will lift you up above the miry muck on eagle's wings. In Isaiah, he says he will lift you up because Jesus loves you. And don't keep putting it off right now. If you're fortunate and blessed enough to hear this message from Gemma today and come before the Lord, just give it up. Give it up. Just say, Lord, I'm too tired. I'm too tired. I need you, Lord. I need a new life. I need a new spirit. I need a new heart. Well, you've come to the right place. Jesus is your best stop for today. Amen? Glory be to
Hallelujah.
God.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Lord.
Hallelujah.
I heard the Lord say that he's going to heal the pain and the suffering of the loss, that there has been great loss, great pain,
yes,
that
Lord.
The enemy has stolen things that were near and dear
yes,
to
Lord.
You, that
yes.
you worked so hard for.
Yes,
and the Lord.
Lord
says, if you will believe me and keep on going forward and walk in faith
yes,
and
Lord.
Keep on working toward that goal,
hallelujah.
The Lord says, he will bless you,
thank you
and
Jesus.
He will restore the years that the cankerworm and the palmer worm and the locust has eaten,
hallelujah.
And the glory of the latter house will be greater than that of the former. Believe God that what is coming
yes,
is going to be greater
hallelujah.
Than what was in the past. And the Lord just wants to heal that hurt, heal that pain,
yes,
heal
Lord.
That sorrow. He just wants to take away, hallelujah, that suffering and that disease.
Thank
He's
going to
heal that disease in Jesus' name.
Thank you,
well,
Lord.
I just want to thank you, Pastor Charlie, for being with me today. It's been such a blessing. And Charlie, you come to my prayer meetings on Monday nights and Friday nights in West Los Angeles.
Yes.
So it's such a blessing. If you'd like to come too, I have meetings every Monday night and Friday night at 7:30 p.m. You can go to my website, gemmawinger.com, if you'd like more information. Also, I have a radio show on KKLA 99.5 FM in the greater Los Angeles area. And you can go to kkla.com every Saturday night at 11 o'clock p.m. Pacific Standard Time. And, of course, I'm on Cross TV every Wednesday at 5:30 p.m. You can go to crosstv.com for archived shows, as well as to my website, gemmawinger.com, for archived shows. And you can go to YouTube at Gemma Winger, hallelujah, to see my music videos, as well as my interview shows, my teaching, and my preaching. Well, God bless you. I love you. Jesus loves you.
Thank you, Lord. And we love you, too. And go out there and get a new heart. Cry upon the name of Jesus, and you'll be renewed and restored.
God bless you. Thank you, Charlie. I'm Pastor Gemma Winger, and you're watching Beauty for Ashes. Turn it all around.
Thank you, Lord.